In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet, Proportional Parts in Triangles and Parallel Lines. Quickly, let's look at number one, ignoring the measurements. In this worksheet, we're going to be using a theorem, and that theorem is the triangle proportionality theorem. It says that if a line is parallel to one side of a triangle and it intersects the other two sides of that triangle, then the line divides those two sides proportionally. So the larger triangle is what we're looking at, and we have this line that is parallel to one of the sides, and it intersects the other two sides. Therefore, it divides the triangle proportionally. So that means if we have triangle A, B, C, and this is segment XY, and you can see that XY is indeed parallel to AC, then AX over XB is going to be proportional to CY over YB. So now understanding the triangle proportionality theorem, let's go over number one. And our directions are to find the missing length indicated. So in number one, this length, let's call this X, over this length of 15 is going to be proportional to this length of 4 over this length, which is going to be 14 minus 4, since 14 is the total length of that side of the large triangle, and we want to subtract 4 just to get this length. So 14 minus 4 is 10. Now we'll cross multiply and solve for x. So x times 10 is going to equal 15 times 4. So 10x equals 15 times 4, which is 60. And when we divide by 10, we get that x is equal to 6. So 6 is the solution in number 1. In number 2, setting up our proportion, our indicated length is this entire side. But before we solve for that, we need to know this side. And let's call this y. So y over 25 is going to be proportional to this length, which is 24 minus 15, which gives us 9, over this length of 15. Cross multiplying, y to 15 and 25 to 9, y times 15 will equal 25 times 9. So 15y equals 225. And we'll divide by 15 to get y. And y is 15, since 225 divided by 15 is 15. Now 15 is the length of y, but we're looking for this length, the entire length of the side of the large triangle. So that's going to be 25 plus y. So 25 plus y gives us our indicated length. And 25 plus y, which is 15, will give us 40. So 40 is the missing indicated length in number 2. In number 3, we'll set up our proportion. 8 over 20, or we could also say 20 over 8 is going to be proportional to. Now, since I did the long side over the short side, I have to be sure to do the long side over the short side. So that's our missing length. Let's call this A over 18. Now we'll cross multiply. 20 times 18 equals 8 times A. 20 times 18 is 360, and that's equal to 8A. And when we divide by 8, 8 goes into 360 45 times. So 45 is equal to A, which is our indicated length. 45 is the solution in number 3. And number 4, before we set up our proportion, let's solve for this side length. Since we're given the total side length is 12 and this shorter side length is 2, I know that 12 minus 2 will equal this side length, which is 10. So 2 over 10, or we could say the longer side 10 over the shorter side 2, is going to equal the longer side 15 over the shorter side, let's call that y. Cross multiplying, 10y equals 2 times 15. So 10y equals 30, since 2 times 15 is 30. And when I divide by 10, I'll get that y is equal to 3. So our missing length is 3 in number 4. In number 5 and 6, our directions are to solve for x. However, we're still using the triangle proportionality theorem in setting up proportions. Calculating this length, this is going to be 45, which is the total length, minus 5x. And calculating this length, that's going to be 36 minus 20. 36 minus 20 is 16. So we'll say 16 over 20, that's going to be proportional to 45 minus 5x over 5x. Now we'll cross multiply. 16 times 5x equals 20 times 45 minus 5x. 16 times 5 is 80, so 80x is equal to 20 times 45 minus 5x. I'll divide by 20 since I know 20 can go into 80 evenly. 20 divided by 20 is 1, and 80 divided by 20 is 4. So 4x equals 45 minus 5x. Next, I'll add 5x to both sides so that my terms with x are on the left. 5x will cancel out, and 4x plus 5x is 9x, and that's equal to 45. Now, all I need to do is divide by 9 to get that x is equal to 5, since 9 times 5 is 45, or 45 divided by 9 is 5. So 5 is x in number 5. And if I wanted to solve for this side, I would plug 5 in for x. So 5 times 5, this side length, would be 25. And 5 times 5 is 25 up here. So 45 minus 25 would equal 20. And number 6, I'll calculate this side length and then set up my proportion. If the total length of this side is 28, then 28 minus 8 will give me the length that I'm looking for. 28 minus 8 is 20. So I'll set up my proportion. 20 over 8 is going to be equal to 3x minus 5 over 10. Cross multiplying, 20 times 10 equals 8 times 3x minus 5. So I'll distribute my 8 and I'll also multiply 20 times 10. 20 times 10 is 200, and that's equal to 24x minus 40, since 8 times 3x is 24x, and 8 times 5 is 40, and that is subtracted. Now, I'll add 40 to both sides. When I add 40 to both sides, I'll get that 240 is equal to 24x. And dividing by 24 will give me that 10 is equal to x. So 10 is my solution and number 6. And I'll go ahead and stop the video here. Before you continue on to the next video, click that subscribe button, like this video, and go ahead and share this with your peers. Now, in the next video, I'm going to be completing numbers 7 through 12, starting with finding the missing length indicated. If you have any comments, leave them below.